دكتور مصطفى،
حياك دكتور كريم، كيف حالك؟
أهلا وسهلا، كيف حالك أنت؟
يا إحنا قديش سعيدين جدا 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 أول حضورك معانا، وإنني معك يعني من مكان بس بعيد 10-15 كيلو عن الكوت كمان.
شكرا جزيلا. يعني يوم أمس تكلمت معي، قلت سأحاضر بفلسطين، قد ستذهب إلى فلسطين زين؟
سعيدين دكتور، إنه في بقول المادة زي ما حكيت لك، مادة الأدفانس أرتيفيشال إنتليجنس، هذه أنا بدرس فيها في طلاب الماجستير مثل الباتشلر ديجري يعني، وعندهم فكرة عن الانتولوجي، عن الشويري، عن السيرتش، عن اللوجيك، وما درسناش احنا الايجنت بشكل تفصيلي، بس كان شابتر 2 عندنا اخذنا بس في 5 دقائق شو انواع الايجنت وانواع الانفايرمنت، فانه تعطينا شوي تفصيل اكثر في موضوع الايجنت سيستمز. طبعا الحضور هم طلاب في الماجستير، وفي الغالب عندنا في الماجستير هم عاده بيكونوا موظفين، كل واحد عنده وظيفه. يعني قدم نفسك انت كمان في الموضوع.
السلام عليكم جميعا. ابدا
نعم دكتور.
اوكي، إذا معكم أخوكم محمد كريم بوزوبع من المغرب مدينة الرباط. أنا أستاذ جامعي بجامعة محمد الخامس وبمدرسة المهندسين، يعني تعلمت عدد من أقل المدارس المهندسين بالمغرب. أشتغل على الأجهزة في الذكاء الاصطناعي مالتي ايجنت سيستمز، وأيضا على المعالجة الآلية للغة العربية. يعني إذا تحبون نبتدئ في الموضوع أو لا يكون دردشة أولية كما تحبون.
بتحبوا تسأل شيء عن الدكتور، عن أكثر عن تخصصه، عن الجامعة تبعته، هي جامعة مرموقة في المغرب، وليش في المحاضرة في حدا عنده سؤال؟ في طلبات بيقولوا يعني احكي لنا عن حالك شوي.
كيف
الدكتور خريج فرنسا؟ مضبوط.
لا انا درستني بعد البكالوريوس بالمغرب، ذهبت الى كندا وحصلت على الماجستير وعلى الدكتوراه بجامعه لافال في تخصص يعني الحاسوب للكمبيوتر ساينس، وبالضبط الارتفيشال انتليجنس ومالتي ايجنت سيستمز بالضبط. وبعد ذلك رجعت الى المغرب، يعني منذ سنه 98 وانا بالمغرب واشتغل بالجامعه، يعني تقريبا ربع جامعه لي في المغرب وانا مستقر فيها منذ تقريبا 7 سنوات. ويعني حتى ربما هناك الويب سايت اعطيكم اياه وتشوفوا يعني السيره الذاتيه او للبيبليكيشنز ولا المشاريع ولا اي شيء يتعلق بالجامعه وبال الاكتيفيتيز نتاعي بالجامعه. الايميل ولا والويب سايت اذا تحبوا يعني تفاصيل اكثر. وبشغل منذ 5 سنوات اشتغل اكثر على الان على المعالجه الذاتيه للغه العربيه اكثر من المالتي ايجنت سيستمز. اعتقد الدكتور جرار مثلا في الديره التونسيه اللي نحكي على الانطولوجيه، ونشتغل على مشاريع اخرى فيما يتعلق باللغه العربيه. هل هناك من الاسئله ولا يعني تفاصيل الان ولا
خليها؟ تفضل تحب تبدا.
اوكي. هل ترون الديسكتوب تاعي ولا لا؟
نعم يعني شيء قاعدتي.
كيف ناو؟
نعم. تفضل.
اوكي. في الحقيقة أنا أشكر أولا الدكتور مصطفى الجرار صديقي هذه الالتفاتة وعلى هذه الدعوة. وأنا صدقوني يعني أكثر يعني حضرت ليس بالمغرب فقط ولكن بكندا وبدول أخرى، و يعني الفرحة كبيرة جدا عندما يتعلق بالديار الفلسطينية، وتعلمون يعني المكانة الخاصة لفلسطين عند جميع المسلمين، ويعني فرحة كبيرة جدا وأنا يعني أتصرف بذلك. ف أحب أن أبدأ في الموضوع، وبطبيعة الحال سأتكلم باللغة الإنجليزية، وستسمحوا لي أنه مدة طويلة لم أتكلم باللغة الإنجليزية، فربما ستكون أخطاء، يعني إذا في أسئلة ممكن المقاطعة. فكما قلت من قبل يعني كنت حضرت سلايد واحد حتى أقنع نفسي، فأنا أسوشيت بروفيسور بكما قلت جامعة محمد الخامس بالرباط. الريسيرش انتريتس ار ارتفيشال انتليجنس سيستمز اند عربي ناتشورال لانجويج بروسيسنج. الايميل تاعي وهل ويب سايت اذا كنتم تريدون يعني اكثر معلومات اكثر حول هذا الموضوع. If we if we look at what are the trends now for computer science, to explain why are we interested in studying multi-system. Let's take a look at what is happening recent years in the computer science field. In terms of ubiquity, you know that. But microprocessors are now, their cores are very reduced and their size also are very teeny, and that's why companies like Intel, etc., we can imagine that a very next future computers are used everywhere, but computers, but we can expect that, as we already know, mobile phones already contain microprocessors, and any hardware in the near future would be to include microprocessor. This first remark. The second one is that these different components that may include a microprocessor may be interconnected between them because of the availability of the connection in internet and Wi-Fi connection between all these components. If we see the second point, the fact that computers now can compute very complete, very complex tasks, and tasks because of this, their complexity could be considered as a sort of intelligence. And if we combine these three points, what would be the word in, let's say, 10 or 20 years later? We have many hardware with microprocessors interconnected between them and computing and completing complex tasks. And then, even if we consider one component to be intelligent, but have to study something else, what is it? we have studied how these hardware are they going to interact between them? Are they going to negate? Are they going to cooperate, etc.? Are they going to be grouped between them, etc.? So these are some kinds that should be studied in the context of multi-agent systems. Artificial intelligence itself or alone is not enough because it considers only one component and not a diversity of components. So with this, we could also expect that as human beings, we have the tendency to delegate all our tasks to computers. Now, if we think from our perspective as computer scientists, we usually, when we talk about computer science, we think about bits, bytes, loops, whatever, etc. But if we would like to program such systems, these loops, etc., these regular concepts are not enough, but we need to use something complex, which is not only object, like in object-oriented programming, but we should use agent-oriented programming in a very near future as computer scientists. So imagine, for example, one scenario in which I have an individual human being that wishes to travel somewhere. Instead of into account all his preferences and trying to find the best package to travel, let's imagine using his laptop or his mobile, he just indicates his different preferences to his computer, and his agent by himself will negotiate with flying companies, with rent car companies, with hotels, in order to find the best package. This, as you already know, some of this already exists using the internet, but not exactly as human beings do, and not every regard in one package. Okay, so you can imagine that in the near future, some scenario would be possible. But if we imagine this is the objective, this agent is going to communicate his preference, human being is going to communicate the preferences to the software agent, because the software agent in this case should understand the preferences of the human being. In addition, the agent should be able to compare the different offers. It shows also some specific algorithms in order to be able to negotiate the prices that would be out to him. So now, how in the multi-agent systems could also be seen, or how it could fit in my computer science curriculum? As you know, with the internet, we have many servers spread all over the internet and all over the world, many information, many software, etc. And we would like, as human beings, we are is to delegate all our tasks to agents instead of having to do the task ourselves. And if we imagine that some agent, some software, virtual agent is able to do the task, it should be able not only it necessitates the interaction between the human being and the agent, but with the agents themselves. And this necessitates the study of multi-agent systems and not just one software agent alone. Now, let's do a more advanced thinking. Has this industry, or has this discipline been used concretely in the industry? Yes, from 1991, it has been used by U.S. forces in the 1991 Gulf War. U.S. forces deployed in intelligent distributed logistics. It was not, for etc., but it was just for the logistics purposes. So the deployed and intelligent distributed logistics planning and scheduling program that involved, and you can see 3,000 vehicles, cargo and people. So it means from this that the vehicles, the cargo and the people, all of them they had a sort of microprocessor that would enable the system to know the exact position of every vehicle, cargo, and people in the US or in Iraq or in Kuwait, etc. So, and this necessitates the use of multi-agent system, because if we don't have multi-agent systems, this means that the had to use a central institution that would give orders to the different cargo people, etc. But now the cargo and people were able autonomously to make decisions, and this is very important. The NAR has also used the agent systems from 1991, where a mission called Deep Space was contained an agent based system that was able to autonomously make decisions by itself without waiting for human beings from Earth to give them orders. Because for previous spacecrafts, they had a 300% managing the mission by sending orders from Earth, and this takes a lot of time because the order goes from Earth to the mission space millions of kilometers far from Earth, and this takes a lot of time. And of course, these kind of spacecraft were more expensive and less robust to unexpected events. So they decided to give the spacecraft itself the possibility to make its own decisions, and this was possible because they considered the mission Deep Space as a software agent, autonomous software agent. And recently, as we may know, the NASA launched two robots on the Mars planet. Do you know this?
Yes, you did, Doctor.
Okay, perfect. So, and they have two robots on Mars that are now exploring the Mars planet. And one of them is called Spirit, and the other one is called Opportunity. And they are, scanning the Mars planet. They are taking some samples from the ground, etc. You imagine that these two robots, even if we consider each one of them as to be intelligent, but something else should be added because they need to cooperate. They need to exchange information between them. And we have to consider one robot intelligent is not enough, but it should be considered as a multi-agent systems because they have to interact, they have to exchange information, etc. And moreover, from France World Cup that took place in France in 1998. As you know, there is a World Cup every 4 years. And every 4 years also, there is a World Cup of robots that is called RoboCup. And they look like they are imagining that by the year of 2050, they imagine that a fully humanoid robot is going to win against the human world soccer champion team. And of course, this could not be possible without the use of multi-agent systems discipline. Let's go now. That was just to give you an idea about the different possibilities, how this discipline could be used concretely, and what are the trends in computer science that for us to study this discipline because it is very important. Right. Now, let's go back to what you probably already know in terms of intelligence and what should be added to a model of intelligent entity in order to give the possibility to this entity to reason and to behave inside a multi-agent system. Okay, this model tells us that an intelligent system should have a learning process or a learning module. It should have a reasoning module. It should have planning module, a module to take actions, and also a module to communicate to other entities and within an environment. All of these are using, of course, some knowledge. This is enough to be considered as a intelligent entity living inside the multi-agent system, but it should be expanded. So what are we going to study to see how to expand this model of an intelligent entity? So Dr. Jarrah was saying that we have studied machine learning, ontology would go here as general knowledge. If you study learning, this goes here. If you study, for example, searching, this is considered as reasoning process, etc. This is just for one entity and not for multi-agent system. For this reason, what are we going to see, if we have time to see everything, of course. I just made an introduction about agents of multi-agent systems. We're going to see how to represent knowledge for an agent, what are different kinds of interactions. And this, of course, all interactions are not, this is something that is not, that does not exist in the context of artificial intelligence, because we have just one entity. Interactions start the time we have two agents, three, etc. So communication, how to communicate, what are different kinds of conversation protocols, etc. What are different kinds of applications, or organizations, sorry, and what are the type of agents that could be developed. Okay, so let's start from the beginning. So now I'm using my starting to course, let's say. So from an perspective, what is the objective? We are focusing as a computer scientist on the individual cognitive capabilities, and we have only one processor computer. One computer that tries to solve one problem. As you know, we have different kinds of these systems, such as the Turing test, expert system, machine learning systems, whatever, etc. So the idea is just one system solving one problem, and that's it. Almost years ago, they said, okay, if we would like to reduce the complexity of systems, we should consider different distributed artificial intelligence, where, as you see, one problem but different artificial intelligence components, and this is called distributed artificial intelligence. And this concerns situations where several systems interact in order to solve one problem. Okay, this was considered as a multidisciplinary field because we were concerned with the study of artificial intelligence, but also social and organizational sciences, and of course, distributed computing. But we are not yet on the multi-agent system discipline. This is just distributed. What is the difference? Of course, there are some benefits for studying distributed artificial intelligence because we have modularity, which reduces the complexity. We have the speed because of the parallelism. We have reliability because of the redundancy, flexibility, etc. Okay. To be able to understand the difference in terms of architecture between distributed artificial intelligence and multi-agent systems, let's take the example of the puzzle. Let's take, can you see the my mouse moving on the screen?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, perfect. So here is the puzzle. Imagine I have different intelligent systems, every one of them trying to solve the puzzle problem. So I see, for example, I have this piece and this piece. I see that I can participate, and I participate in solving of the problem. So one common problem here, and all of these people are trying interacting between them to solve this puzzle problem. In the context of multi-agent systems, it's completely different because the puzzles themselves are considered to be agent and taking part of the problem. Okay, so he has an agent. In this slide, this is not an agent, but I have a software autonomous agent. There is a semantic change here. From the distributed artificial intelligence, I have the role is, the control is on the module's behalf. In the context of multi-engine systems, give the agent themselves and knowledge to be able to interact. Okay, this is the context of multi-engine systems. That was that why I was saying at the beginning, you can imagine that a very near future, different hardware, whatever the hardware could it be, if we include with it a microprocessor, this microprocessor inside this hardware could be considered as a multi-agent, as an agent, and behaving in the context of other agents. And this should have means to be able to interact, to understand, to be intelligent, etc., etc. Because this part is really important that you understand before I move forward to other parts of the slides. I mean, understand the semantic change from AI to distributed AI to multi-agent systems. If you have questions, you can read them.
We have questions? Some? No. Yeah? No questions? Here, Ahmad is asking again, can you please repeat the difference between distributed artificial intelligence and multi-agent systems?
Okay, so the difference between distributed artificial intelligence and multi-agent systems, that's the question, right?
Yes.
Perfect. So, you should consider this one as a module that is controlling my agent, while the agent is controlling himself, right? So imagine, for example, I have a program on the computer. In general, I should have the interaction or the some being asking the agent itself to do something. What agent system perspective, the module itself would have enough information to be able to know that it has some objective, that it has to do this job or that job.
بمعنى آخر بالمالتي ايجنت سيستمز كل موديول هو بيتحكم بنفسه نعم كل المعرفة اللي بتلزمه حتى يعمل اكشن على غيره بينما في الاي اي عادة بيكون في حق بيتحكم
بالضبط يعني هنا يعني الشيء الاساسي هو autonomous behavior يعني جميع المعلومات يعني الأساسية حتى يعني drive autonomous هذه الثانية مهمة جدا هو the second thing is that in general here I have one common problem while here I have different kinds of situations we don't negotiate don't have conflict resolution here. While here I have conflict resolution because I don't really agree with you on everything. If I, for example, I am an agent that is to which I delegate the task of negotiating some price for me, if my agent would be to use the price in order to be able to gain money for him. Other agents go to end goal, but the goal is to make the price very high, and then start the negotiation because our goals are conflictual.
It's clear. Okay.
So now let's take some definitions. What is an agent definition? A definition. It is the component in the environment upon which it can act, which has a perspective, perceptive capacity, and has a partial representation of its environment. Could ask why partial, because no one of us can have a complete representation of all the environment or all the world. Everyone of us has only a partial representation of the world, which can communicate with others. We is attempting to achieve an individual goal, that I was saying before, individual goal, and which has an autonomous behavior. That behavior is the consequence of its observations, knowledge, and interactions with others. So, an entity, an agent, an entity that can be considered to be an agent as soon as it is able to have local control over different processes, vision, communication, knowledge acquisition, decision making, etc. So, with this definition of what is one agent, we can consider a multi-agent system as an intelligent system which is composed of autonomous agents that are interacting in order to cope with or to compete. So, not all cooperation, but it is possible to have competition. So, a multi-agent system is what? E, which is the environment, for example, the metric space, this object. Past elements that inside the environment that could be perceived, updated, deleted by agents, other agents, and relationships between these objects and agents. For example, I am this agent within the team, this is my teammate, while the other agent is, for example, the agent of another team, etc. So the relationships play a key role in the interactions between the agents. Different kinds of operations, agents to perceive, communicate, act, etc. So let's take a very simple example. I have, for example, a metric space here. You can see metric space. And for agents, see those are of the same type, while this one is of another type. So the goal is to capture the prey by surrounding it. Let's consider those are predators, while this one is a prey, right? To capture the prey by surrounding, predators. Problem, what is it? Is how these predators are they going to coordinate their in order to catch the prey, right? Other problem, what if you have six predators and two preys? Are you going to divide in two groups? Are they when six of them surround only one prey, etc.? This is something that is familiar for us as human beings. But for a computer, for computer software agents, what are you going to do? The examples clear?
Yes.
Okay. So with this, a multi-agent system could be open, where agents freely come and go out. Coffee, for example, could be closed as a football game, where I have only one number of agents within one team. It could be homogeneous, and it could be also heterogeneous. Okay, this one is also very important, these categories of agents. Which kinds of agents? With the first very simple one, what is called reactive agents. Those agents that react to changes in the environment or messages from other agents. This kind of agent is not able to reason about its intentions. Actions are performed as the result of just training some rules or executing stereotyped plans. So here, the main point to focus on is the intent. Dr. Mustafa, you were saying minutes ago that an agent, this is something that has enough information to be able to act itself. Intention, does it have a goal? Does it have something that would make it act? Okay. Here, a reactive agent does not have an intention, does not have a goal, does not have a desire. It just acts, and that's it. This is the first kind of reactive of agents. I'm showing you the another example. The second one is the intentional agents. So an agent that is able to reason on its intentions and beliefs. Intentions are belief, and beliefs are kinds of knowledge. And to its plan of actions and execute them. One is the social agent, which is an intentional agent, but that possesses explicit models of other agents. It is aware of the relations or the relationships that exist between him and the other agents in the system. So the examples of these. These three kinds of agents could be categorized this way. We have the reactive agents that follow a biological perspective, and like beings, etc. But cognitive agents that follow or respect the sociological perspective. And he can categorize them again in intentional and social agents. This type of agents, reactive agents, they have no representation of the environment, have no historical memory, they have no, their functioning mode is very simple. Like, I have stimulus from the environment and then I get an answer. So it follows a biological organization. This kind, as I was explaining before, they have an explicit representation of the environment. They are very important, historical memory, and this gives them the possibility to have sort of example is reasoning or case-based reasoning, etc. If we don't have historical memory, I'm not able to launch such reasoning. The plan, it can take actions and make anticipations on the future, and it respects social organization. So, if I take the example of reactive agents, it is the kind of, for example, ants. One is not considered as a very intelligent system, but the whole system, the whole multi-agent system is considered as very intelligent. يعني تعلمون يعني النحل أو النمل يعني when you see the whole system فغير نقول هذا عجيب سبحان الله ماذا يفعلون يعني هناك تركيز هناك coaching between them. From where comes this intelligence, this individual intelligence, but it is a system intelligence, right? Why? Because they follow very simple actions. They have a sort of, as I was explaining here, they have the function mode is a stimulus and then they have an answer. For example, if I take our examples of rules, the first rule of our is to say, the first one is explore. And I did not something, and I did nothing, I just walk randomly. I explore the ground. Mm-hmm. The second I find, if I am outside and I am free, and I pick something, then I take it. The rule says, if I am outside, I am full, which means I have just allowed this rule. I put mark, and I go back to the base. And what ants in general do. Rule, if I am outside and I clear that perceive a mark, then I go to it. So I explore it, I didn't find something, or I see that someone has put a track and a mark somewhere and I go to it. And put, if I am at the base and I am full, I put the object on the base. So to be able to see the what we could do with this kind of agents, can you please play the the 2 days ago a movie I'm showing you on my
the one of the ants,
yes. Yeah. I would explain exactly this one. Please on my laptop.
Everything's a little When we have it, we are just start playing it.
Just to show you, to be sure, this is the one I want you to play on your on your part.
Yes.
All
right.
I know it looks like a mouse or a moose, but let's pretend he's an ant. Every ant is a little state machine, with states like explore, recruit, and carry food. When ants move, they sometimes leave a temporary chemical trail they later try to avoid. This helps them explore open space. This hill and some green ant food. Ants emerge from the ant hill and randomly explore the area looking for food. Explore mode finds food. It switches to recruit mode and starts wandering randomly, looking for food to recruit. As a recruiter ant moves, it leaves a blue pheromone trail behind it, also known as a recruitment trail. The recruitment trail fades out over time. When a recruiter finds an exploring ant, it recruits it, and the newly recruited ant follows the freshest recruitment trail backwards, traversing it from fresh to oldest pheromone, and always trying to take as small steps in age as possible. In this way, recruited ants hopefully follow the gradient of the recruitment trail back to the food. Once the food, recruited ants carry the food back to the nest, recruiting ants along the way, and leaving their own recruitment trail behind them so that they and their recruits can find their way back to the food. Which direction their nest is, but not where any other ants are or where the food is. I make assumption that ants know where their nest is to simplify the simulation. It is not terribly unreasonable, as some species of ants keep track of landmarks to navigate or even have limited eyesight. So once the ants are recruited, they try to follow the pheromone trail that is most similar in age to the one they were on. This trick works well and can let two pheromone trails cross without confusing the ants. It can also lead to dead-end situations where ants cannot find an older trail to follow. To help avoid this, I added a counter to each ant that causes the ant to reset its pheromone age memory after the ant has failed to move for some time. Also, other counters help prevent ants from getting stuck in either recruit or recruited mode for too long. Here's an example where some ants are stuck, but then either a pheromone trail ages or the ants reset. They find their way to the food. Here we have ants with two food sources. The rest of this video contains a clip of the ant simulation in action.
Video. Okay, perfect. So, what's your reason?
So, I'm in home. I have look.
انها تبحث عن الاكل لما ذكرت المدرسه تبعها انه صار عندها بخزن بالمنور تبعها انه خلص هذا فريق التراك تبعها وبعدها بترجع نفس الشيء
يعني تسمح لم اسمع شيء للصوت بعيد جدا
يعني تمر تقول انه عندما النمله وجدت فود هلا اخذت من الفود وبتصير تبحث يعني تدركها اثر في المسار تبعها للبيت فهي تدرك اثر عشان ترجع للبيت وبترى تحسها انه هو شو هو الممر اللي راحت عليه عشان ترجع هذا كمان هيك ايش يعني
يكون في يعني انتراكشن بين النمل نفسه
يعني بين النمل نفسه ماله
يعني اي واحد يلاقي نمل ممكن تعطيه معلومه عن عن مكان الفود
اللي بيكون يعني لما بيكون نمل مشت لكير طعام هلا خبر النملات الثانيات بطريقة ما بتخبر النملات الثانيات
على الأقل بتلاقيها بتخبراتها بتصير معها في الشغل يعني تروح معها على الفوز بتنازل الطعام للبيت وكل واحد بيقول الثاني لما يصير في أكثر من معه ممكن
يعني وكأنه عصام بده يحكي إنه النمل اللي بيسرح بطريقة عشوائية وعندما واحد من النملات تلك
طعم
فتأخذه وهي يعني بالذات بتخزن المر تبعها في ذاكرتها وبتترك فرحة على المر وعبر النملات الثانيات كمان بصيروا يخبروا بعض من ذلك العبير انه في هون في اكل بطريقة ما بيخبروا بعض وكان حتى يعني ممكن يكون في اكثر من مصدر طعام يكون حوالي البيت بس مش كيف عمل التنسيق بينهم يروحوا على الطعام المعين على طعام A مثلا ومن الملات اللي بروحوا على طعام B فضل
ملاحظات أم سؤال
هذه ملاحظات هذا الفهم اللي يعني كان
نعم جيد جدا جميل نعم دعوني ارجع الى اوكي كان سي ذا سلايد ناو بيرفكت فهذه كانت ملاحظات ربما الملاحظه اللي ثارت انتباه متاعي هو نوع الانتراكشن اوف كورس اتس نوت اي دايركت انتراكشن بتوين ذيس كايندز اوف ايجنتس because as I was saying at the beginning of multi-agent systems that could be considered as an intelligent system in case it has the autonomous behavior, in case it has it can behave with others in intelligence etc but this kind of agents is very we can call it the least multi-agent systems of course these very complicated interactions don't have this autonomous behavior but as you can as the, you saw the fact it has just very simple machine mode the whole agent could be considered as a multi-agent systems because we can some intelligent behavior for the whole system can be exhibited and how the objective is not to study ants, but able to use this model to simulate what is called social life. يعني دراسة مجموعة من الأنظمة كأنظمة الحوت أو النوع من السمك أو أنظمة مثلا عندما كانت المنتع البرس تذكروا مشكلة منتع البرس اللي كان من قبل
يدور كيف تدور بتطير مع بعض
نعم كان مشكل تاع البيرتس من قبل يعني بيرتس فلو اسمه هذا يعني كان في مرض كان في مرض تاع الطيور تنقل
انفلونزا
الطيور بالضبط كان ممكن ان ندرس هذا النظام by simulating it with a multi-agent system using this kind of systems. There are some software that are called software, and actually a software called SWAR. It is an American software, and you can simulate a whole system using this SWAR software, where you say what is the functioning mode of one agent. Simple agent, and you see the whole system how it behaves. Like for example, blue. Or for example, you can study also بعض المدن في في العالم استعملوا reactive agents and this kind of agents to study the flow of cars within one city. You know, simply, يعني أقف في الدور الأحمر. لنظام الضوء كذا وكذا يعني very same functioning mode, and then see how the whole system is, how it could be simulated if we change this or that within the system. بل هذا النوع من الاجنت could not be considered for NASA or for war or whatever. It's not very intelligent system. Do you understand now the difference between them? Clear? هل في
حدا عنده سؤال؟ نعم. اوكي.
Fine. Let's study more. More intelligent agents, and to do so, we should study now different kinds of components. I remind you about the first model I've shown you at the beginning, where in the model of intelligent entity, now something more should be added. What to keep in terms of knowledge? What to add because we are in the context of multi-agent systems? What are the interactions that you would like to engage in? Communicate. This is very important. As you know, we communicate, for example, using TCP/IP, I don't know, protocols, but is it enough for agents? And we have to see it's not enough. We should communicate using something more interesting, like, for example, exploiting use of an ontology and how to design and specify multi-agent systems. Okay, so let's go back to the. Now we're going to talk about the what is that? What are the information, knowledge that we should add within a knowledge model? Within an agent model, give him the possibility to act within the multi-agent system. Let's go back to the agent definition. An agent, what is it? A software component inside an environment upon which it can act, which has a perception capacity and has a partial representation of its environment, which can communicate with others, which is attempting to achieve an individual goal, and has autonomous behavior. This behavior is the consequence of its observations, knowledge, and actions. Okay, now I ask you, if I ask you to design an intelligent agent, and with this definition, what other knowledge are you thinking about that should be represented within the knowledge base of an agent? I give you an example. If I'm talking about individual goals, it means that an agent would have another that is called goal that represents his different goals. For example, my goal is to do a perfect presentation at Birzeit University. Your goal is to understand fully the presentation of Dr. Karim from Rabat. This is a goal. Goal is to get a very grade in your master's degree, etc. You have different grades. You have different goals. So, and in order to be able for it to behave autonomously, it should have, of course, this notion that is called a goal. What is a goal? Okay. Goal, but I could also reason with the intention. My intention is this and that. Of course, an intention is a goal, but with a smaller intensity. It's not the same. My intention is, for example, for you, your intention is to study, to get a PhD program after the master's degree. But of course, your goal is, which has more intensity, is to access in your master's degree. Of course, if I have goals and I have intentions and have plans in order to be able to achieve and satisfy my goal. So, if an agent there is a necessity to be able to represent what the agent is willing to do. And what to do are the different tasks and roles in which an agent can. What are the capacity of different capacities of the agent? Well, if I go back to, if you remember the spirit and the ODC, I don't remember the name of this US, the American robots exploring this planet. They have the capacity, are they able, for example, to carry a rock from ground that is, let's say, that is 40 kilograms, say in English, يعني ثقلها أكثر 40 كيلو. They have the capacity to carry this rock or not? I should be aware of my capacity, of course. Be aware also of the capacities of the other. When I ask someone, please, can you carry this table with me? If I ask someone, it means that I am aware that my capacity is enough to be able to carry this table. And I ask someone to help, and I am aware also that his capacity and mine are enough to be able to carry some table. Okay, and so we should present information about others, about the environment, about domain information, etc. The question, how to represent this information, how to update them, what are associated semantics, are these different kinds of knowledge related between them, etc. So here, if we talk about multi-agent systems, for example, capacities, commitments with the others, etc., are not kinds of knowledge that we represent when we talk inside in the artificial intelligence context. But this is something that is necessary in the context of multi-agent system. Okay, so I'm not going to details here, but these are represented, this knowledge. McCarthy, which is an American researcher in the US, said, legitimate to attribute intentions, etc., to machines if this attribution expresses the same information for machine as well as for humans. Is what called mental state. I don't know how to translate in Arabic, but any حالات ذهنية, هذه حالة ذهنية, يعني أنا يعني أرغب في كذا وكذا, هذه حالة ذهنية تساعدني على ال على يعني ال تجعلني أقوم بهذا أو بذاك. هذه الحالة الذهنية, هذا هو ال intention notion, the cause, etc. And so we would like them, if we would like them to operate autonomously, they should have this mental state, هذه الحالة الذهنية, low to understand, analyze, and predict the agent. In terms of motivational knowledge, we could say that this category is important because it guides the behavior of agents. They when we talk about goals, and before I talked about intention, but we can go in more details or deeply and say that we have not only goals and intentions, but we can study something very and say some we don't have only intention, but sometimes I have the desire and I have the wish. And in general, we use this human beings, we use this kind of knowledge when we behave, when we act, etc. رغبتي كذا وكذا ليس يعني هذا ما أريد أن أفعله اليوم غدا. رغبتي مثلا أقول كل جميع المسلمين تحرير القدس, لكن it's not something that is a goal now that we are acting, etc. But هذا حلم لجميع المسلمين. يعني the different actions that we perform are because of our goals, intentions, but sometimes because of our desire and wishes also. Okay, we can also associate other kinds of knowledge, such as deontic knowledge, emotion, and personality. Deontic level, what is it? Those are the authorities, duties, interdictions, permissions, etc. This is what guides our behavior, for example, within the society. In the سياقة, هناك interdictions, هناك permissions, etc. And this is what guides this is what our actions. We have also the personality level, and this is what influences the way agents make decisions. Am I kind? Am I polite? Etc. Etc. And the emotional level, and we know this has lot of influence in the behavior for us as human beings, but also for a conversation. So this emotional level influence the behavior of agents, especially during conversations. We have some researchers have categorized them in 24 kinds. The conditions lead the operation of these, some conditions lead the operation of these emotions, or emotions. An unexpected and desired event that happens leads to the operation of gladness. كنا نعتبر أنه مثلا الحاسوب لا يمكن له أن يعبر عن شعور الفرح أو شعور الحزن أو ولكن مع هذا التعريف if an agent that has a goal of for example finding the best price for his human being for tomorrow and does not find it then مثلا يعني شعور الحزن يعني لم أتمكن لم أفلح في القيد بكذا وكذا. Very important also I consider it after the motivational knowledge the second very important knowledge which is the soul knowledge. It indicates the relationship that exists between agents inside some society. Most of these mental states remain static for a long period of time. For example, يعني الطريقة سأتكلم بها مع ميري في العمل ليس هي نفس الطريقة التي سأتكلم بها مع الذي في المنزل. يعني نفس الإنسان. يعني this kind of relationship guides and have exhibit some problems. I give you an example. أفترض أنا جندي عادي وأتمع في المين وأنا جندي عادي أطلب منه I need to go door يعني أن أطلب يعني يطلب إنسان إلى إنسان آخر أن يفتح أو يغلق الباب شيء فظيع لا شيء عادي ولكن because of this relationship يعني العلاقة ما بين هذا الجندي والجنرال الجندي في الحقيقة لا يطلب من الجنرال علاقة يعني هي طلب عادي ما بين إنسان وإنسان آخر because of the existence of this relationship then it could have an impact on the actions of the relationships between the agents. يعني ال lines of knowledge واضح لأن تقريبا انتهيت هذه الفقرة فإذا كان عندكم أسئلة من ناحية knowledge social motivational personality etc. Is it clear?
بدك تسألي؟ ها؟ يعني دكتور إذا نلخص بنقول يعني إنه لا في applications ممكن نشوفها بطريقة agent يعني بالمعارك ولقتها يعني بس أنا بجوز في تطبيقات الموبايل applications تطبيقات المالتي ايجنت سيستم في الموبليكيشن في ولا
لا لم انتهى بعد المحاضره متاعي أنا اريد ان اعرف هل هناك اسئله فيما يخص نولج فقط فيما يخص
النولج يعني هل النولج بتكون شيرد على نفس النولج بتكون شيرد لكل ايجنت عادة
It should not be shared because every agent is autonomous. If I go back to,
طب في معلومات شير كيف الجندي كيف يعني الجندي بده يعني بيعرف إنه اللي بيحكي مع جنرال
نعم هل انتهى السؤال؟
نعم، يعني السؤال كيف اذا فيش شيرنج للنوليدج، كيف يعرف الجندي انه بيحكي مع جنرال؟
فهمت، يعني هذه يعني this is one knowledge that both of them should have of course.
طبيعي الجواب دكتور، طبيعي في بعض الاشياء هو المعروف يعني بيرنج لهاي النولج،
هناك معلومات since every agent is autonomous is alone is independent from the others it has his own knowledge right of course some knowledge are known by others right some of are private means that I'm not giving the others the possibility to know all what I know because my relationship between them of course many of these knowledge are known not only by me but by the others and I know that they know them and also they know that I know it but I'm proud to say it's shared it's known by the two yes but not shared
more than shared okay clear
نعم
حاضر اوكي
اوكي
نعم
اوكي now terms of interaction okay we said it's important to talk about interactions for multi agent systems because different components and they have to interact. For example, they have to plan all together, they have to coordinate actions, they have to get in coalitions, they have to negotiate, etc. I'm going to explain some of them. Okay. What is multi-agent planning? You know, the plan is to find the different tasks that I should execute as a plan to satisfy my go. This is a definition of one executing one mono agent plan. Now, in the context of multi agent planning, the multi agent plan is the process of creating a multi agent plan. So, multi agent plan is a plan that is generated for multiple agents. We have different kinds of this multi agent plan. The first one is what is called the centralized multi-agent plan. It means that I have one agent that is considered to be central and have other agents. So one agent that is called the central planner is responsible for building the multi-agent plan. For example, you, Dr. Jarrah, what you do, you plan for your whole class and the others don't have, and the others just have to follow what you are going to propose to them. So I have a central planner. For in the traffic control problem, as you know, we have a problem when we have to control the traffic around airports or between different طائرة in English. شكراً. So, we have one central planner among them that is decided after negotiation that creates a multi-agent plan to be performed by the planes involved in the conflict. And for example, in the airport, the Sydney airport, we have a system called WASIS, and you can check with Google, and you would find that is a system that exists in Sydney airport. And have a multi-agent system that manages the traffic in the airport. It is done using a sort of central plan. This kind of planning It is called the centralized coordination for action plans. What does it mean? Plans are formed first by individual executors. So the individual forms its own plan. Then we all of us send our plan to a coordinator. So this coordinator agent collects the local plans and tries to solve the conflicts. So most of the work in centralized multi-agent planning is the synchronization and conflict detection. Because, for example, I'm going to propose in my plan, I'm going to execute task A, and another agent is going to execute the same task. And he's going to have a tendency. So the centralized or the coordinator has to detect these conflicts and try to solve them. And the last one is the fully distributed, the fully distributed of the partial plans. Here, all agents are at the same time planners, but also executors. So I have no agent that has a global view of the group activities. Of course, in order to solve a conflict, if we detect any conflict, there is a need of initiation and coordination, or even negotiation between agents.
Any سؤال هون؟
Okay, and this is what I said at the beginning. I'm going to go back. If as we said before, an A would have a goal. Okay, أن أذهب من الغرفة كذا إلى الغرفة كذا مثلاً، أريد سفر من هذه المدينة إلى المدينة القريبة إلى مدينة أخرى. This is a goal. I want to travel from one point to another point. So for example, for us in Morocco, I would like to go from Rabat to Casablanca. I need to find what are the tasks that I'm going to execute in order to satisfy this goal. Of course, how much do I have in my with me? And with the money, I should have multiple plans. I either, for example, take the train, or I take the bus, or take, I don't know, I go with one of my friends, or by feet, if I have money, etc., etc. So I should find a plan in order to execute and satisfy my goal. Is now the definition of a plan clear or not? So shall I explain again multi-agent planning, or it's clear?
No, it's clear. Multi-agent planning, yeah, it's just coordination of plans. Yeah.
Okay. So the second one is coordination of interaction. Why should we coordinate? Because the actions of the agents are dependent, and in order to handle some constraints such as time, money, and of course resources. And the problem is that no individual agent has enough competence or resources to solve the entire problem alone. Such as the example of carrying the table that I was explaining before. I have, for example, other examples. But say what the coordination, how are possible in the context of multi-agent systems. One possibility is to talk about centralized coordination. Suppose I have two robots. One of them has the goal. The first robot, robot one, so I have here six pieces named from A to B, C, D, and F. So the first robot going to have this situation. He would like to have B on the table, and he would like to have A on the table, and he would like to have C and A. Why? For the second robot, he goal is to have this situation. What others? And for the robot one, this is his goal, whatever the situation of the others. Right? So then, we try to find a plan for the first robot. We are going to, first of all, he's going to put B on the table. If I put B on the table, it means I will take it from the, from here and put it on the table. Okay. Then I'll put A on the table. Meanwhile, I'll put E on the table and then put D in the table. You can take a pen and sheet of paper and follow exactly what I'm explaining, and you would see that very easily. And after putting everything on the table, he's going to put C on A and get this. Okay, so he does not take, does not pay attention to the other pieces. The second robot is going to put B on the table, E on the table, etc., etc., after reach his goal. As you can see, this is possible if he's alone, robot alone. And this was possible if robot one, robot two is alone. But what if they are both trying to solve his own problem, but with the same resources? They should coordinate here, because we don't have a conflict here. In this case, they are going to join their efforts. One of them is going to put B on the table, and not both of them, because they are going to have redundancy. One of them is going, for example, to put E on the table, and not both of them, etc., etc. And if you follow, they are going with coordination, they are going to reach their goals, and their goals is this situation with the coordination. So here the coordination for the agents, a joint plan is or found by combining all the individual plans. Joint plan consists of all the actions that all the agents need, and has the two, and it has the two partial ordering which make it valid. So this possibility of where two agents can coordinate their in order to solve some individual problem and not one common problem. Okay, now if we talk about negotiation, which is more complex, of course, because we can imagine that agents can have this. So, agents with different goals may interact using some form of negotiation. And negotiation is the process by which a joint decision is reached by the two or agents, each one trying to reach an individual goal or objective. So, using a negotiation process, agents try to resolve conflicts that may be raised, of course, due to action. So, first of all, the agent communicate their positions, with conflicts, and they try to move towards an agreement by making concessions or searching for alternatives. In order to be able to negotiate, we have some, we talk about some features such as the language, what is the language that will be used by the agents, what is the protocol in order to let the agents change, and what is the decision process each agent uses to determine its position in the concerns that they do and the criteria for agreement. Imagine, for example, in general, they use this negotiation process. They positions, ولكن في غالب الأحيان تكون يعني تخلي عن هذا الموقف وتخلي عن هذا. So this is the kind of negotiation. إني أثك بهذا على أساس أنك تسمح لي بالشيء الآخر. For example, when you would like to buy something, it's the same. So I imagine on my mobile platform, some agents that should negotiate the price of some hotel, so it should have this decision process. What is my position and how am I going to negotiate have the best price for hotel or whatever? Very quickly, what are the properties of a negotiation? Efficiency, stability, simplicity, and distribution. I'm not going to bother you with this. Just let's skip it. Example of the this is just it was a research work was done in 1983 that shows the possibility of a negotiation. It's not very important. We have also the auction mechanisms. And then go to the communication. So interactions, we have seen that we have the possibility to propose plan, a multi-agent plan. We have seen three different kinds of multi-agent plan. We have seen the possibility of coordinating our actions to be able to find an individual goals and how we can cooperate and coordinate actions. And the third one is the negotiation.
كريم في هنا صراحة إذا أكثر من ربع ساعة بدنا نأخذ بريك ونرد نرجع
كما تحبون
أنت طايل معك أنا نأخذ عشان بعدها يكون في أسئلة كمان لكن شوي وين بتحب نأخذ بريك
والله مشكلة تحب نحن نوقف الآن نوقف الآن ربع ساعة
ذكاء
أكثر من فضلك وقت نذهب للصلاة وأرجع.
طيب نحن في انتظارك يا دكتور.
خلاص سترجع لنا.
أوكي إذا تقريبا 10 دقائق ربع ساعة أرجع.
إن شاء الله.
شكرا.
Thank you.
يلا نفهم الشيء وش انا بدي في مجد انا بدي في مجد
عمل بدني خاص
الانجلاند هنا في جيومات يشوفون يخاف يجوا بوشيز متابعين البرزنتاسيون تسمعون لي تشوفون
الذين على ايفون حضرات على ايفون الاسم اللي
مش عارف
نحن جئنا
مرحبا
ان كنت
انا جاهز يا اخي جاهز. عندي سؤال، كم وقت تبقى تقريبا؟
دقيقتين.
وقت تحتاج دكتور؟
والله عندي تقريبا 87 سلايد والان وصلنا الى سلايد 49، يعني 50 تقريبا 37 سلايد ما زالت. ربما تستغرق.
خليني اسال انه على الخمسه كانت محاضره عندنا. انا بدي اعطيهم محاضره ساعه. هو شايفكم. كان اشروا لي اني انا ما اعطيهم مش المحاضره. خشيرهم.
اوكي تفضل.
محاضرة اسمها دكتور ممكن تنهي بثلث ساعة ولا لا؟
بساعة
20 دقيقة يعني
applications إذا في إمكانية تركز
بعد سلايد أمر عليهم بسرعة
تفضل دكتور
Okay, if I just to you, we're talking about we have seen that it's necessary to about interactions and knowledge for agents. Now it is clear that agents have to communicate because we have multiple agents, and of course, if they want to trade, if they want to negotiate, if they want to communicate with the human beings, they are. It's necessary for them to have means to communicate because there is a need to cooperate, negotiate, resolve conflict, exchange information, etc. These agents need a common language. They, it's not possible for them to have everyone its own language. They have a common language. And this language should be used by heterogeneous agents and not for only one kind of agents. And that, according to what we have seen in terms of interactions, these agents should have the possibility to communicate, to request, to make comments, to get answers, to make assessments, etc. These kinds of apps not only send information but track and pass it. To communicate, it's necessary to communicate not only the content itself, but also the syntax and the semantics, and even when I not talk about also the pragmatics. Of course, that the communication is very, the cost is very high, so we should take into account this. Different categories of communication that we might have is, of course, it would range from no communication, but in case the agent should be aware of everything, which is not possible. We have no agent that is aware of everything. To the other side is a high-level communication that resembles the human communication. So the first kind is no communication. We put a sort of primitive communication using fixed signals, etc., which is very limited for agents, and would have on passing the plans because they have to exchange plans, etc. The high level communication. So, as you know, we could have something that looks like a natural language messaging, but in context of multi agent systems, researchers have proposed the use of what is now agent communication language. This is something that looks like natural language, the natural language, but also that is better and of high level communication if we compare it to more regular communication. It should be of course efficient, based on standards, level. So it means that we should be able easy to extend without changing the language. Using, for example, ontologies, and that supports several syntactic representation, and it is of course it should be expressive. Okay, I'm going to skip this one. So, it is an agent communication language. In this context, communication message should be considered also as an action. Why? Because in general, when we execute an action, we act. In response to this action, it should be the same. When I communicate something to someone, I act and on something executed from the other agents. For purpose, researchers seen the philosophical background and used what is called the speech act theory. This is a theory that studies philosophically the speech act that human beings are using. And so, as I said, analyzes philosophically the speech acts that we use, and each act in this case is considered as an act. Okay, I'm going to skip this one. A speech act is composed from what? A propositional content, which is the claim, the text, speech, the hearer, the time, the location, etc., but also, this is very important, the what is called the locutionary force. And have five categories and directives. If, for example, Unix, you, all of you might be might know Unix, right?
Yeah.
Okay. When I execute a command, it means that I ask the machine to execute something. This is a directive. If I LF, it answers me. I have this file, I have this directory, etc. But it's not enough. All what we have for operating systems, MS-DOS or Unix, are just directives. But software agents, if they want to be able to communicate with human beings and between them, they should be able not only to express directives or ask questions, but they should be able to assert something. They should be also express something, to declare, etc. Those are five kinds of communicative speech that are studied at the philosophical study. For if I take the lecturer of this course or of this lecture is a Moroccan. Here, what is it? Is it a directive? It's not a question. I just assert, okay, that the lecturer, this is the content of the lecturer of this, but all this content, P, is going included inside an assertive. Each one is asserting to each and to that lecture is. For example, an assertive, what is it? It means, I'm just asserting. I like you, close the window. Committed, I will. I engage myself. I promise, etc. I expressive, excuse me, congratulations. Declaratives. I named the city Rabat, for example. Some of the communication languages that have been proposed is FIPA, which stands for Foundation for Intelligent Physical Agents, that is a non-profit association in which IBM, you have Microsoft, you have many companies. And the purpose of FIPA is to promote the success of emerging agent-based applications. You have URL FIPA.org. So as I was saying, there are many companies, Alcatel, Boeing, British Telecom, etc., IBM, HP, whatever. Many companies have agreed to promote this language. Universities, we have the DARPA, which is the US agency, etc. So, what is the component or structure of a message? The big message structure, I inform, I request, or and this label that we have here inform us about the type. Is it an expressive? Is it a request? Of what kind is it? Then, the type of the communicative act or speech act, then I have the sender, the river, and then I have the price, the content that you express in any language you want, using conceptual graphs, using, I don't know, whatever you would like to use. And in reply to, the protocol, the link, and also the ontology, very important. They have to express in which ontology this content is expressed using which ontology to be able to interpret this content. Different communicative acts, I accept the proposal, agree, cancel, confirm, disconfirm, failure, inform, etc., etc. We have different parameters that I presented. We have some protocols. About protocols. When you ask a machine, just ask, and it gives you an answer. But you would need intelligent to be hit as human beings. Sometimes I ask you and you say, oh, I don't understand. And they have to be to you and explain another time. This is what we would like them to be able. So we should communicate using some protocols. Ask, maybe I understand, I don't understand, etc. For example, this is an example. Here I have a request from one agent that is called I, and I have the answer from agent J. Could you read with me, please, this example? How can you read this one, the first one? What is it? How do you interpret it?
Request. Yes. That is I, the receiver is J, and the dependent is that action J, develop book 17, location.
Change that the agent I is asking agent J to do what?
Deliver books.
Deliver books in a
specific
position, okay? And then they are using a protocol and they give an order, a sort of ID to be able to answer, okay? So here, the agent J answers. What is answer? I agree, okay, I can do it, okay? And then the content deliver, but with A, priority important, and this priority is very low. I accept, but I'm not going to execute it now. Later, please. And the thing that we have never seen this in computer science up to now. This is new here. I accept, but I will do it later. Okay? And see, with the same in here, using the same protocol. So the kind of protocols that I can use if I ask someone to do something, maybe I don't understand, maybe I'm going to refuse completely, or I propose to do it but with some conditions, etc., etc. Formal model, I inform, if you inform, I believe, I'm not going to go into details. The example, I think, is clear. So just to go back to communication to summarize, communication is important to be able to interact between agents, and it should be to be able to interact in any kind, it should be of high level. Something that looks like human language. And if it is the case, then we should not only, the agent should not only be able to understand directives or the orders, but it should be able to understand and assert the commit. I commit myself to execute this action for you, but not now. Tomorrow, after tomorrow, etc. Okay? We have one of the all companies are where they are, I don't know how to express it in English, they know that there is a necessity to propose a standard like the FIPA language. Okay. Now, this is one of the last parts of my presentation, the application. If we go back to 1995, the research, this researcher was saying in 10 years time, more new IT development will affect any consumer products will contain embedded agent-based systems. Okay, so just to overview the rapidly evolving area of software agents, present the real challenges and potential benefits of agent research, and the overview of the typology of categories of agents. So, in terms of typology, we can think of agents that can cooperate, agents that are fully autonomous, and agents that are learning agents. And between all of these, the best one is, of course, these smart agents that can cooperate, learn, that is autonomous, etc. This kind of agents and kind of interface is. So all those that are developed are within this typology. For example, the interface agents. What is it? It is an agent that behaves behalf a human agent on his computer. So my computer might have an agent that listens to that observes what I'm doing on my computer and can delegate to him many tasks I would like to do. So I have a user here using some machine, some computer, and then I have an agent. And so this is, as you can see, is observing my interactions with the machine. And it can use also the user feedback and programming by example. And what I communicate with my machine using application. So me, for as a user, I interact with the application, and user interact with this application. And the agent is able to observe and imitate my job. But also, if I delegate, for example, the first scenario I presented at the beginning, if I would like to have a user agent to which I delegate to find a travel package using an application, the agent would take my goal, consider it as his own goal, and using all the knowledge about me and what it has in terms of knowledge, he is going to interact with other agents. You know what we have? Simple negotiation, for example, but also commit with me using level communication. So what we can, I was explaining. Those some examples. Kaba is an example of a interface agent that has been developed at MIT in the US that can buy and sell items on the web. You can ask Google and it would lead you to this Kaba application that is a sort of interface agent application. Applications could be, of course, too many kinds of disciplines like network management, air traffic control, like Sydney Airport, etc., etc. You have many kinds. You can imagine any discipline where the agent application could be applied. I'm going to present just to give you an example, the health agent. If I'm an agent, it can do all of these, for example. It has a medical diagnosis. Where can an agent technology be of assistance in the whole field of medicine? The different needs or future needs, primary care are rapidly displacing specialty care. Few patient visits, of course, if you are using the agent. Shorter hospital stays, because before, for example, I diagnosed that I have a problem at home, and instead of having to go to the hospital or to the clinic or whatever, I first of all use my mobile agent and ask him about taking a rendezvous for me, ask about what to do very urgently before going to the hospital. And the medical agent would know in detail all my medical history, know your medical problems and the treatment you need, and then the medications you need, and then communicate, for example, this with pharmacy agents. Remind you to take your medications, remind you about your medical appointments, et cetera, et cetera. We can imagine all of these if we have an AI technology applied to the health discipline. Okay. So the last point is to talk about if you would like to now talk about systems from which part. Okay. You have different software that appear for active agents like war. If you like to develop a very multi-agent system, social multi-agent system that can interact, communicate, negotiate, etc., we have to use some platforms. I personally participated in the development of a platform for developing intelligent systems, and this platform is called Brain Platform. And one of the components of this platform is to be able to develop multi-agent systems. Some available platforms like JED, JSON, JERS. This JERS platform has been developed by British Telecom. It's free, can download it and use it if you want. The problem is that most of them are concentrating their effort only on the communication part. And one of them is really comprehensive, allowing the possibility to develop a ontology for the agent, to develop different kinds of conditions, different kinds of interactions, etc. So with this platform that is called Amine, we are giving the agent the possibility to have multiple processes using the knowledge part, using conceptual graph layer. There is an ontology layer, and we have different agents like dynamic ontology, prolog, etc. Very simple example that of a multi-agent system that has been developed, and you can see I have very simple agent that is called Menon, and another one called Andre, and are communicating between them some information. This is very simple and basic multi-agent systems. The two processes are on the same machine. Now we also were able to simulate a very simple application that is the sort of قصة للأطفال. The story says we have a bear that is named John. It is John. He was angry. Where to find food? He asked his friend Asher. It is Asher. Who told him where to find this food? Believe it was not easy to simulate this very simple story. It seems very short, but if you go, once you start programming, you would find that playing, coordinating, it's a communication, etc. It's not easy to program. Just to show you the some details, have some examples of knowledge that we had to present. We represent the positions of all objects, the positions of all the agents, and are the possible foods. We have fish, as you can see here. You have the fish, you have honey, you have other fish, you have etc. etc. Here also we had to represent now plants. For example, some plants of John is to know already what is the food position. In this case, he has to move. So he has to move, then find some food, and then satisfy his hunger. Inferences. For example, if I consider that Asher, the bird, is a lion, then John would not trust him directly. He would distrust the answer of Asher and take it as mushini sahih. So some plans that could be executed here. If I have the goal to satisfy my hunger, then I should execute some plan. And two possible plans. The first one, if I know the location of this, it might be very big for you. But when you go to the machine, those actions that seem to be basic, we have to give it and to program it inside the machine. If I know the location of the food, I move to the food, and then I satisfy my hunger. Now, if I don't know the location, I may, for example, ask some friends of mine, receive the answer, and then he will see the necessity of having a communicating process. And I receive the answer, I go to execute the first plan. This is a sort of protocol. I know the Arthur position. I move to go Arthur. I move to him. I receive him, I ask him, gives me the pattern position of the food, I move to the food, I know, etc., etc. He expresses everything using the concept graph for them. You see, for example, one of knowledge for Beer John is the knowledge about the food. He has, for example, at position 311, there is some food called food 1, etc., etc. Is the path that he has to follow, go from this position to this position, etc., etc., until getting to a food that is named honey, for example. You can program it using Java. Are you familiar with Java?
Yes.
So the application. Okay, so the class that is called Rinaldo application, and you have the name. So I have two arguments. This one represents my first agent that is called John. And this is the class of John. We are in this predefined class. With this class, I say, I define my agent that is named John. You are going to use this. You have three parameters here. The first one is some program that defines John. The second one defines the element. And this one defines the ontology for agents. The third one is called Archer. And here is the program that defines knowledge of Archer. The second defines the environment, and the third one defines the ontology. You can also remark that both of them are using the same ontology and even in the same environment. And I create a multi-agent system that contains the two arguments, which means the first agent and the second agent. And then, if you see here, I try to execute only one goal. John try to satisfy the goal. What is the goal? If you see, it is expressed in a conceptual graph for rhythm. One sentence satisfy the hunger, and the intensity of this hunger is some level that I'm going to try.
Can I ask you, because there is a lecture, we have to continue 1 hour, and there will be like half an hour after the يعني كم نص ساعة عشان الطرق عندنا بعيدة وهذول جايين من مدن بعيدة والتشيك بوينت فيعني بيصير كثير ممكن أسأل سؤال معلش إذا تسمح لي
And so, just to show you that here, we can create our multi-agent system. This is agent John. This is the agent Archer. Every one of them is autonomous and executing its end. And here you have the source control agent that knows everything about the two agents. So to show you the video that I sent regarding the robot. So if you have time, you can please. Where you can see it's really a multi-agent system because it has two groups of agents, two playing all together, and each group has its own goals and trying to reach the goal of scoring, of course, goals. You have interactions between them, etc. Stop here since you don't have more time, but if you have questions, so please feel free.
في أحد يحب يسأل تفضل
دكتور how can we consider ubiquitous as a agent can we consider ubiquitous as a multi-agent system how can we consider ubiquitous can we consider it as a multi-agent system or
which one can I consider which one
ubiquitous agent
ubiquitous
consider it as a multi-agent system or another type of artificial
يعني هي multi-agent ولا لك سؤال
يعني هي the trend يعني التوقع المستقبلي للمعلوميات بصفة عامة يعني بأنه استعمال عدة مايكرو بروسيسرز all over some software, some hardware. In يعني ممكن نتوقع أنه في القريب العاجل يعني 5-10 سنوات بما أنه there is this ubiquity everything contains a microprocessor, then there would be a need to develop this multi-agent system discipline. هذا الملاحظة.
Thank you.
بكون في سؤال كمان هون.
نعم.
وين بشكل بسيط العلاقة بين الايجنت سيستمز والمالتي بروجرامينج او اللي بنسميه مالتي تاسك، يعني تاسكينج غير بس المالتي بروجرامينج، وهيك سؤال يا عصام، يعني المالتي ايجنت والمالتي مالتي بروجرامينج،
يعني what mean by multi programming parallel programming
programming.
Okay, when you talk about parallel programming, it means that you have one component that tries to divide the tasks or the statements on different machines, on different processors.
Mm-hmm.
And the programmer is هو يتحكم في الطريقة التي يريد فيها أن تكون يعني ال instructions parallelized. ولكن multi agent systems يتحكم، كل واحد يتحكم في نفسه.
يعني يتبع سلوك وكأنه شخصية مستقلة، ولكن
نعم ahead of time take the actions to know exactly what to give to each processor to know exactly what the statements to do. Another of course to be signed. ولكن هو يعني he is aware of what he is doing.
في عبير دوين بدها تسأل عن الانثولوجي، تفضل يا عبير.
بدي اسألك دكتور عن مكونات الانثولوجي بين اللي بتساعد على الايجنت انها تحكي مع بعض، ايش بيكون جوا الانثولوجي؟
يعني هل في انثولوجي ولا ابلكيشن انثولوجي؟
اوكي، انثولوجي تتدخل، هل تسمعوني؟ انقطع.
نعم تفضل.
هي تتدخل عندما نتكلم عن لانجويج او عن الكوميونيكيشن. لماذا؟ لانه اذا كان واحد ايجنت يتكلم لغة والاخر يتكلم شيء اخر، فعندما اعطيه مثلا بوزيشن اوف ذيس او لا اتكلم عن الكار، اتكلم عن اي شيء، فيجب ان اكون متيقنا على انه الطرف الاخر نفس الانطولوجي عنده نفس المعلومات التي استعملها.
اذا هذه بتكون ابلكيشن انطولوجي ليست دون انطولوجي.
It should be semantic. The most important point is to be sure that the other part or the other agent is interpreting the same way I am interpreting the content of my communicative act.
يعني زي ما حكى الدكتور كريم، هو عادة الانطولوجي هنا بيمثلها في الكونسبتوال جراف. الكونسبتوال هي عبارة عن لغة معينة، كيف تقول او ام، احنا عادة بشيء نسميه او ار ام، ولكن انا يعني لغة تمثيل ثانية برضه بيك فترتس امرس اسمها كونسبتوال جراف. في سؤال يا عبيد؟ في دكتور سؤال، هل في مارجنز ابلكيشن ايفونز على الاندرويد في ترند جديد طلع ولا
as far as I know لما تقدمت في الاول، يعني هما الاغلبيه نتاع المالتي ايجنت سيستمز اللي نجحت بطريقه هي الرياكتيف ايجنت، هذه نجحت كثير، مثل سوارم، البيز، الانت، البيرد، اول وات سيميليتد.
شو اكثر المناطق الاريا، يعني الارياز اللي هي تتعرض لريسيرش في هذا الموضوع؟ وين الريسيرش مركز في هذا الموضوع؟
في كل ما يتعلق بالمثلا الترافيك نتاع السيارات، ولا الترافيك نتاع الطائرات، وايضا من طبيعة الحال كما تعلمون من الناحيه العسكريه ايضا
عسكرية وترافيك. يعني أنا أفسر
زي مثلا في كل سيارة بتطلع ايه انت وصير سيارة تحكي مع بعض وين في ترافيك يمسحوا بعض تجيش هاي الطريق روح هذيك الطريق وبتناقلوا بيانات والى اخره.
نعم
احنا يعني سعدنا جدا 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 في وجودك معنا وجودك الاونلاين معنا وان شاء الله يعني ربنا بيكتب وتيجي عندنا يعني بشكل يعني تحرر البلاد ولكن يعني ان شاء الله بنضل على اتصال وانا ان شاء الله بوعدك نرد يعني ارد اعيدها هاي المحاضره في كورسات ثانيه لان اول تجربه عندنا في الدائره انه يعني عملنا سلسله من المحاضرات امتداد العربي وهذا بتوقع يعني ان شاء الله بتمر والطلاب عندهم تبعات ففي اي حدا عنده اهتمام بالريسيرش طبعا دكتور كريم ان شاء الله يعني موجود جدا في الابحاث في النشر بروسيسنج في العربي بنشر لهم بروسيسنج في الاردنت كمان لهم بالاردنت فبنضل على اتصال احنا وياك
لكم يعني جميعا وانا في الحقيقه يعني انا تصرفت اكثر منكم لانه يعني التواصل مع اخوان فلسطين هو شيء عجيب ورائع بالنسبه الينا واشكركم على التواصل وان كان في اي سؤال في ناحيه المالتي ايجنت سيستمز او من ناحيه الارابيك لانجويج بروسيسنج فمرحبا واهلا وسهلا وان شاء الله نكمل هذا التواصل وهذه العلاقه الطيبه ان شاء الله.
دكتور تشرفنا.
شكرا
أنا كذلك شكرا لكم جميعا.
سلام.
مع السلامة.